Is it straight or in reverse?
Straight, sir.
Straight. Is it clear to all of you?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. No, sir.
The first point. Can you read out the first point?
Respiration. Aquatic animals breathe in dissolved oxygen from water.
Oxygen.
Animals that breathe atmosphere oxygen.
Oxygen. Oxygen is absorbed by different animals. All of these items have cell. This special structure increases the surface area which is in contact with organic.
Okay. You can read
oxygen rich atmosphere.
Have you followed the previous video, YouTube video?
Yes, sir.
Okay, in that we have started respiration topic, right? Respiration in animals. Okay. Yeah. So, according here, I have written all the points of respiration point by point. Okay. So if you want, you can make the notes also. Right. As we already have discussed, aquatic animals, they breathe in dissolved oxygen from water, because oxygen is available in water in the form of dissolved oxygen. Whereas terrestrial animals, the animals that live on land, they breathe in atmospheric oxygen. They breathe in atmospheric oxygen. And in different animals, different respiratory organs are present by which oxygen is absorbed. There is one common thing among all these different respiratory organs from different animals, that is having a special structure inside them. This special structure, it increases the surface area which is in contact with oxygen rich atmosphere. What is the importance or common thing of this special structure among different respiratory organs? This special structure, it increases the surface area which is in contact with oxygen rich atmosphere. And exchange of oxygen and carbon dioxide, that is gaseous exchange, it takes place across this surface area. So, as exchange of gases is taking place across this surface area, this surface is very fine and delicate. If the surface is not fine and delicate, then gaseous exchange cannot take place. So, wherever the gaseous exchange is taking place, that area must be fine and delicate. Okay. As this surface is very fine and delicate, it has to be protected. So, to protect this structure, this structure is placed inside the body, that is within the body, not outside of the body. If this structure is placed outside of the body, what will happen? Since it is fine and delicate, this structure may get damaged. But the structure is placed inside the body. The air is present outside the body. So, how the air has to move to that area? And this structure is going to get CO2 rich air from the body. So, how that CO2 rich air should come out from the structure? So, there are some passages and there is a mechanism for breathing. What for these passages are? These passages, they carry the air, they carry the oxygen rich air to this structure, and they carry the carbon dioxide rich air from this structure. The mechanism of taking that oxygen rich air is called inhalation. The mechanism of pushing out the CO2 rich air is called exhalation. Both inhalation and exhalation together is called breathing process. So there is a mechanism so that the air can be taken in and the air can be taken out. So passages and mechanism are very important for this structure. Let us see how the passages and mechanism are going to work in human beings. In human beings, air is taken in through nostrils. Nostrils are the entry points of nasal passage. Like how mouth is the entry point of alimentary canal, in the same way, nostrils are the entry points of nasal passage. Nasal passage is lined by fine hair and mucus. Nasal passage is lined by fine hair and mucus. What is the use of this fine hair?
Yes, let us wait. Many people are waiting in the lab, it seems.
Okay, what is the use of the fine hair and nostrils? The fine hair and mucus, sorry, not nostrils, the fine hair and mucus, they filter the air, because air will contain many dust particles and many other smaller non-useful or harmful components. So all this dust and harmful components are filtered with the help of fine hair and mucus. The nasal passage leads to throat and lungs. So the nasal passage and throat together, they form air passage, and this air passage enters into lungs. Throat is covered by rings of cartilage, which ensure that air passage does not collapse. What is the purpose of rings of cartilage? Rings of cartilage ensure that the air passage does not collapse. The air passage in lungs, it further divides into smaller and smaller tubes. The air passage in lungs, it further divides into smaller and smaller tubes. These smaller tubes finally terminate. They finally terminate means end up in balloon-like, many balloon-like structures. The balloon-like structures that are present in lungs are called alveoli. Alveoli, they provide the surface for exchange of gases, and the walls of alveoli, they contain an extensive network of blood vessels. Actually, these are the fine forms of blood vessels, we can say blood capillaries. So the walls of alveoli, they contain an extensive network of blood capillaries or fine blood vessels. Now coming to mechanism of breathing. In mechanism of breathing, two processes are there. They are inhalation and exhalation. How inhalation takes place? Inhalation, that is breathing in process, breathe in. During inhalation, ribs are lifted up and diaphragm is flattened down. So that when ribs are lifted up and diaphragm is flattened down, the chest cavity increases. When chest cavity is increased, the pulmonary volume also increased. Pulmonary volume means the volume inside the lungs. Volume inversely proportional to pressure. When pulmonary volume is increased, obviously the air pressure inside the lungs decreased. So the air will be sucked in. So this is about inhalation. Coming to exhalation or breathe out process. During breathe out process or exhalation, ribs are flattened down and diaphragm is lifted up. Diaphragm is lifted up. So the chest cavity is decreased and pulmonary volume also decreased. When chest cavity is decreased and pulmonary volume is decreased, automatically the air pressure inside the lungs is increased. So the air is pushed out of the lungs. The air is pushed out of the lungs.
Right.
Upon inhalation, air is filled in expanded alveoli and blood, it brings the carbon dioxide rich air from all over the body. At alveoli, CO2 is released in alveoli from alveolar blood vessels and O2 is taken up by the blood of alveolar blood vessels. So this process is known as gaseous exchange. What is gaseous exchange? Giving the CO2 rich air to alveoli and taking the O2 rich air from alveoli into the blood of alveolar blood vessels. Once gaseous exchange is over, the CO2 rich air is present in alveoli, which will be pushed out from the lungs. This process is known as exhalation. How exhalation is taking place? By the ribs are flattening down and diaphragm is lifted up, chest cavity is decreased, pulmonary volume is decreased, and air pressure inside the lungs is increased. So air is pushed out. During breathing cycle, lungs always contain a residual volume of air, which is also known as tidal volume. Why residual volume of air must be present? The residual volume of air, it gives sufficient time for oxygen to be absorbed and for the oxygen, carbon dioxide to be released. The residual volume of air, it gives sufficient time for the oxygen to be absorbed and for carbon dioxide to be released. If the body size is very small, like in unicellular organisms, the absorbed oxygen can be sent to different parts of the body by diffusion pressure alone. So, if the body size is very small, like in unicellular organisms, diffusion pressure alone is sufficient for the delivery of oxygen to all parts of the body. Whereas in the case of larger animals, it is not possible. In the case of larger animals, diffusion pressure alone cannot be sufficient for the delivery of oxygen to all parts of the body. In larger animals, as diffusion pressure alone is not sufficient to transport the oxygen to all parts of the body, respiratory pigments take up this job. Respiratory pigments take up oxygen from lungs and carry it to different tissues. Respiratory pigments take up oxygen from lungs and carry it to tissues. In humans, hemoglobin is the respiratory pigment, and this hemoglobin is present in red blood corpuscles. Hemoglobin has very high affinity towards oxygen, so that the oxygen that is taken in into the blood of alveolar blood vessels, is going to bound by hemoglobin and get transported to all tissues. CO2, unlike oxygen, it has high solubility in water. CO2 is more soluble in water than oxygen. So CO2 from all body tissues, it is transported in the dissolved form in our blood plasma. You know how much surface area that the alveoli are going to provide? How much surface area that the alveoli are going to provide? 80 meters square. So 80 meters square surface area, it is very much enough for the exchange of gases. If respiratory pigments are not there, then how much time that it is going to take in order the oxygen to be transported from lungs to our toes? It will take around 3 years. So we must be very thankful to respiratory pigments, because of which only oxygen is getting transported very fast. Okay. If you are having any doubts, you may ask. You can ask the doubts. Students, are you listening to me? Speak louder.
Yes, sir. I want to take notes, sir. Yes. You show us, please, once again.
Can you speak louder? It is not audible.
Sir, we want to take our notes. Sir, we want.
You want? Hello?
Notes.
Notes. Okay. Since this platform, I am thinking that it is not supporting correctly to give full clarity, I may make the same video, okay, for YouTube channel again. In that, clearly I will give these notes, okay. Or if you can write, is my voice audible to you?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Is it louder enough?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
But your voice is not louder enough to me. Initially it was louder enough, but now it is not louder enough. I don't know why.
So you can send PDF to...
Okay.
Our voice don't have any problem, but video lagging.
I think only this frame, it will provide us some writing area of the board. Okay. Right.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Now here, in this topic, there are certain important things. Like, you know what is respiration already, you have learned the definition. What is breathing? One inhalation and one exhalation together is known as one breathing. And process of inhalation and exhalation together is known as breathing. Human respiratory tract
It has got totally nostrils, nasal passages, throat, bronchi, bronchioles, alveoli. And this bronchi, bronchioles, alveoli, these three parts, they are present in lungs. They are present in lungs. Can you see it from the board clearly?
Yes,
yes
sir,
sir,
you can see clear, sir.
Yes, sir.
Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Which one is more clear? On paper or on board?
On board, sir.
Board only?
Board, sir.
Okay,
board.
Instead of using paper, shall I use only board then?
Yes, sir. Only board, sir.
Only board is enough for you?
Yes, sir.
Okay, right.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
But can you, did you write this thing? Cadets, did you write? What is breathing?
Yes, sir.
And this is respiratory tract, second one. This is breathing, this is respiratory tract. Ajay, your voice is not at all audible. Hope you have written.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir, we have written.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Next, in this process of breathing, passages and mechanism of breathing are very important. What for the passages? Passages bring in O2-rich air and take out CO2-rich air. Passages bring in O2-rich air and take out CO2-rich air. Did you write?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Over, sir.
I have a doubt.
Yes, sir.
Whatever I have written, is it mean? Are you able to watch it correctly or in a mirror image type?
No, sir. It is clear, sir.
It is clear.
It is clear.
Yes, sir. Okay. Yes, sir.
It's correct, sir. Correct.
Because in my mobile, I am able to watch it in mirror image form. Since I am taking the video from front camera. Okay, right. Next. Hope you have written it.
Yes, sir.
The mechanism of breathing, inhalation. You just observe your own breathing. When you inhale the air, what is happening in you? The ribs will be lifted up and the diaphragm is flattened down. It can be seen when a person is sleeping, you can see that the person's tummy will be lifted up. But actually tummy is not getting lifted up. It is the diaphragm, it is getting flattened down so that you feel like the tummy is lifted up. Accordingly, even ribs also will be lifted up. So during inhalation, ribs are lifted up and diaphragm is flattened down. Diaphragm is a
muscular sheet which is present below the rib cage. When it is flattened down and ribs are lifted up, the chest cavity, it becomes larger. When chest cavity becomes larger, the pulmonary volume, that is the volume inside the lungs, it increases. As the pulmonary volume increases, the air pressure inside the lungs decreases. Air always moves from high pressure to low pressure. Then compared to atmospheric air pressure, now inside the lungs the air pressure is decreased. So the air will be sucked into the lungs. Once the air is sucked into the lungs, the sucked in air, it fills the alveoli. Then gases exchange takes place, CO2 rich air is entering in alveoli. Now the ribs are flattened down and the diaphragm is lifted up so that the chest cavity becomes smaller in size and the pulmonary volume will be decreased. The pulmonary volume will be decreased. When pulmonary volume is decreased, that is, the space inside the lungs is decreased, the air pressure inside the lungs is increased than atmospheric air. Then the high air pressure is there in lungs and low pressure is there in atmosphere. So the air will be pushed out from lungs. The air will be pushed out from lungs into atmosphere. This is how the mechanism of breathing is operated. The mechanism of breathing is operated. Hope you have understood. During inhalation, ribs are lifted up and diaphragm is flattened down. What is resulting? Chest cavity is becoming larger. Which increases pulmonary volume. When pulmonary volume is increased, the air pressure inside the lungs is decreased. When air pressure inside the lungs is decreased, air is sucked in. Write it. Have all of you written it? Have you written it?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes,
sir. Now, exhalation. See, the ribs are lifted up in inhalation. Here, they are flattened down. Ribs are flattened and diaphragm was flattened down in inhalation. Here it is lifted up. Now chest cavity, it has become larger in inhalation. Now it will become smaller. Which makes the decrease in pulmonary chamber volume. When pulmonary volume is decreased, what will happen? The air pressure inside the lungs is increased. than compared to atmospheric air pressure. This makes the air to be pushed out. Is that clear to all of you? Have you understood the mechanism of inhalation and exhalation?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Good.
Yes, sir.
Understood, sir.
Yes, sir.
You might be knowing about the Charles' law and Boyle's law from chemistry. Do you know that?
No, sir.
According to Boyle's law, temperature is directly proportional to pressure. Whereas according to Charles' law, volume is inversely proportional to pressure. If lungs volume is increased, inside that lungs, the air pressure will be decreased. That is what happening in inhalation. If lungs volume is decreased, inside the lungs, the air pressure will be increased, which is happening in exhalation. Is that clear? After inhalation and exhalation, after inhalation, what is happening? Gases exchange is taking place. So oxygen is entering in alveolar blood, which is present in alveolar blood vessels. From alveolar blood, the oxygen should reach to all tissues. In the case of unicellular organisms, they are very small in size. Diffusion pressure alone is sufficient so that oxygen can be reaching to all parts of that unicellular organism. Whereas in larger animals, diffusion pressure alone cannot make the oxygen to reach all parts of the body. If alone by diffusion pressure itself oxygen has to reach, it will take longer periods of time. By that time, all cells will die. So how this absorbed oxygen should reach to all parts of the body? Respiratory pigments, they play the role. What are these respiratory pigments? The respiratory pigments are special colored proteins which will bind to oxygen and carry this oxygen to all parts of the body. In humans, the respiratory pigment is hemoglobin. This hemoglobin has very high affinity, means attraction towards oxygen. So oxygen will be binding to hemoglobin and it is transported along with blood, because hemoglobin is present in red blood cells. As blood is liquid connective tissue, it flows from alveolar blood vessels to all body parts or all body tissues. There the oxygen is delivered to tissues, right? And the CO2, it is having high solubility in blood plasma. Blood plasma, it is more of water only. And CO2 solubility in water is very high than compared to oxygen. The CO2 which is taken from the tissues, it is transported back to alveoli by being dissolved in blood plasma. This is how the oxygen and carbon dioxide are transported from alveoli, in between alveoli and body tissues. How oxygen and carbon dioxide are transported between alveoli and body tissues? Oxygen is transported by being bound to hemoglobin, and carbon dioxide is transported by being dissolved in blood plasma. Right? I write that point.
right? Where to where, you know? Here oxygen is transported from alveoli right to body tissues. Here carbon dioxide is transported from body tissues to alveoli. Right? Is that clear? Write it down.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Understood, sir.
Even if your voice is not much clear, I need to know whether my voice is very clear to you or not.
Yes, clear, sir.
Are all of you able to understand?
Yes, sir.
Okay, Abhiram.
Yes, sir.
Did you write this?
Yes, sir.
Please explain alveoli once again.
Okay, have you taken it?
Yes, sir.
Okay, let us wind up our class today. Let us meet tomorrow.
Sir.
Tomorrow, I think, okay, you are having which period?
Third period?
Okay. So let us meet tomorrow at 10:30. Okay. Same link. Link is not going to be changed for this week. Next week, the previous link which has been posted to you, that I'm going to inform you. Don't worry. Right? Shall I close the class now? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Take care. Bye.
Bye, sir.
Bye, sir.